No. Yeah. Heal me. Thank you.
Difficulties connecting to the stream. Hopefully no one is. Sec and Evil coming up with double MP40 frags. Make that two for, make that another one for Sec, as they will try to make their push forward. Gryzyek is there, and the two of them will edge their way back in towards the middle. About to make their push towards the objective right now. Gryzyek has let the medic go in first, and he's got no ammo. He's just going to blow himself away, though. He's going to blow down his teammate, sorry. And Gryzyek, all on his own now, pushing forward. Engineer got dynamite, yellow, Panda Faust, double. Chaos, he's just saved the dynamite, surely. Can he get the arm in? No, the engineer's going to take down Murozu, still up. Murozu's going to make his move in towards that dynamite. It has dynamite been armed. Holes as we spy Gryzyek making his way forward. They look like they've locked this one down. 7 seconds on it. No Germans in sight except for Butch and Riddler. Riddler about to make his way forward. He's been dropped. He's been picked up. He's got 1 second. Boom! Murozu, double dynamite kill. Poland set the time. It's not a lightning fast. In 15. However, Butch had a real strong German side. We'll be right back here and inside the game of the second half whilst I address some of these problems with Lish. And, well, I have no idea whether what the hell's going on, but we seem to be having other issues as well. So, we will see. 6 minutes on the clock if you are rejoining us, as this cast has been dogged with technical issues. And here we go. We have got Murozu making his way forward. We've got problems with Lish. And, well, I have no idea. Double dynamite kill. Poland set the time. It's not a lightning fast time. It is 8 minutes and 15 seconds. Top fragger there, Butch, 19 and 11, rightly so, Riddler, 17 and 15. However, Butch had a real strong German side. We'll be right back here and inside the game of the second half whilst I address some of these problems with Lish. And, well, I have no idea whether what the hell's going on.
Dynamite planted.
We seem to be having other issues as well.
Dynamite planted.
So we will see 6 minutes on the clock if you are rejoining us, as this cast has been dogged with technologies. And here we go. We have got Rozu making his way forward. We've got Bic and Evil. Bic and Evil both there. Riddler is there too. Dynamite diffused on the side door. Nicely down by the poles there. Evil gonna push forward. Butch and Riddler are there too. Here come the Germans. Evil with a Panzerfaust, about to make his move down onto this bottom level. He tosses through a grenade and is lying in wait. Panzerfaust gonna move in from Evil. Strikes Kryziak straight in the face. There were two poles waiting for him on the other side. And he missed those two. However, the three-man Panzerfaust that he tossed in earlier, certainly just reward for Evil. He got it on the right team this side. As here come the Germans once again, though. It's going to be knife frag from KRC, following up his MP40 frag. Back there, but they are starting to make some headway. They got that first stage down in very good time, thanks to that three-man Panzerfaust, and now they have 5 minutes to get the dynamite down on the bunker controls. Bunker controls, that easy to defend. 5 minutes is ample for the Germans, and for Evil with that Panzerfaust strikes it at that back wall, misses. Kryzek is there. It's almost like a Panzerfaust into the beach upper base. You can, on RTCW, you can almost always land one. And that's what Evil's aiming at right here. Drago with the Panzerfaust. Butch and Riddler both coming up with a frag apiece. Wyzek will wedge one in between them, and that will be Butch. And Kryzek dropped down. Bic, the engineer, is about to make his move. Drago lying in wait for a revive. Sek will play hop, skip, and jump over those grenades. And now there are three Germans about to make their move. The spam continues from the poles, though, and it's nothing but spam, as grenades are just launched through unaimed at these three German players. Sek, Drago, and Bic. The three of them, unharmed, about to make their move. Drago blown away by the rifle nade. Sek called into action, and the Germans are going to have to make their move now. Up they go through the top level, unchallenged almost. KRC the only one there. Sek is waiting for the all clear. Clever engineering here. Sek is on the other side. He's another engineer. However, it's Rozu and Kryzek that have come through. Dropped Drago, Bic, and Riddler. There's the Panzerfaust from an Evil that's dropped Wyzek. He was a medic and had just revived KRC. And might just now will drop him and say hello. Pay a visit. The doctor coming through on the visit and reviving his teammate. So, you're inside the game. Apologies for the technical difficulties experienced here on Braundorf. And I'm hoping that we don't get the next match. KRC coming forward. MP40 frag dropping Bic. He's edging away. 3 minutes and 33 seconds on the clock. We'll give you another ATTV sync up in about, you know, a few minutes. And Riddler now making his way in from the Axis spawn side, edging towards the bunker controls, tosses a rifle nade, bounces off the wrong wall, and now the Allies have alerted the Axis to their presence. However, Sarna covering his right, covering his left. He's got Wyzek to the right. Grenade tossed forward, but Sek is nowhere near it. Riddler and Sek in two minds as to attack or whether to spawn camp. The spawn camping option isn't going to be met because no Axis have spawned. Riddler around, frag dropping Sarna, combination of Sek as well. Why was he pushing forward at that time? Kryzek there, dropping Riddler, the engineer blown down, Gibb picked apart. Other side of the map, though. Coming in from the left is one medic. Coming in from the right, two medics and an engineer. KRC's been down. Not Gibb, though. And Drago and Bic and Butch will make this move in towards the grip bunker controls. They have an engineer waiting for the all clear. The all clear has been given. Bic tosses dynamite down. Dynamite yellow. 30 seconds on that. 2 minutes 40 seconds on the clock to go. Engineer KRC has dropped down. He's going for the defuse right now. He's waiting on it. He's pushed forward. He's waited too long, and Bic's going to down him. Bic's not going to get the Gibb. Evil with the Panzerfaust. There's a Gibb to be had if he wants to fire it off. There are no medics left. KRC needs a medic. The good game has been called. And that looks like that for this game. Evil will wait with the Panzerfaust. The G has been called. We haven't had the second part of the GG, but I think it is. Panzerfaust from Evil blows himself away. And there's a Drago team grenade. 1 second. Boom. Germany up by one. They've taken this first map in some great circumstances. And you've got to love Rondorf. It always produces the time. Well, nearly always. And we'll come back on the second map, which is going to be Supply Depot. But what a strong performance from the Germans there. 6 minutes and 8 seconds is an okay-ish time, but it was the slowish time from the Poles that really, really caught them screwed there. We'll be back on Inside the Game. Well, I can safely tell you, I have made a fool out of myself to that song quite a few times. Most recently this Saturday when it was such a big night that I was still drunk at about 12 o'clock Sunday afternoon whilst eating lunch. However, the previous night I did manage to make a fool of myself to that. And, of course, the Black Eyed Peas, My Hump song, which I'm pretty good at making a fool out of myself. Well, do you not like my lumps? My humps, my humps, my humps? My lovely lady lumps? and so forth. Anyway, we are onto Supply Depot. We do have 12 players, but we have no ETTV because due to some bug, whenever we have a match on ETTV, whenever we change maps, the server dies. I don't know why, but it is true. So, Germany take that map. What does that mean? Does that mean that Germany can take the second map? I don't think so. I think there's a whole lot to be played for there. I think the Poles just had a crack start. You know, maybe they didn't have enough practice beforehand, maybe they weren't ready, I don't know what it was, maybe they weren't warmed up, but they had a crap start, and I think that's all that can be said. And really, we have to look at, well, what are they going to do about that? Well, we've got Supply Depot to do something about that, that's for sure. The Germans are playing well, they're organized, they are German, they are efficient, and that is exactly what that performance was. They took their time. I was so impressed by the German ability to wait. You know, so many games, it doesn't matter with your custom Euro Cup final, so many games to players just run in on their own. Absolutely unnecessary deaths that then screw up attacks. But the Germans, no. They were efficient. They waited. They got together. Every attack counted. And it was that fact that it meant consequently paid off for the Germans this time, and really they have got to, it seems like they have got to have, you know, their, I've no idea what I'm saying here. If you do that, you're gonna have an effect. And that's exactly what we're doing. So, we'll see what they can fix. On, now Sinus, has told me that there's a little bit lacking, I've no idea what I'm saying here. If you do that, you're going to have an effect. And that's exactly what the Germans did. So, we'll see whether they can fix that, whether they can continue with that, or whether the Poles can do something about it. Supply Depot is a very, very difficult map to be efficient on. Now, Sinus has told me that there's a little bit lacking of practice going on by the Poles, so I don't know whether quite the extent to that. However, you know, there's talent in that Polish lineup. We'll see. Speaking of Poles doing well, Avec winning the net games, and Poland are going to be pretty damn happy about that. So, we wait on the readying up of five more players here inside the game. We're on to Supply Depot. You know, if you're someone like Nelly, for instance, who absolutely hates Supply Depot, there's one fact you can never argue with. It gives good games.
Oops.
You know, and that's the question people have to ask. It gives good games. A football pitch gives great games. Why should it be changed? Unless it's at Chelsea. Why should it happen if it's that good? MP Beach in RTCW. It gave great games. Why should that be changed? It's still the best map in RTCW history, so why should it be changed? People still flock to, you know, MP Beach servers. Same with Market Garden. There are still 50-player Market Garden servers up there somewhere that you can join. And the same can be said about Fuel Dump. It gives good games, so what's wrong with it? And that's not me saying, you know, oh, I love Supply Depot, I just want to play it till my heart's content. However, it's a point being raised, and seeing as we're going to play Supply Depot now, I think it's a point that I'm going to stick with. So, we will see. Germany versus Poland. Still not quite ready yet, so we'll be back right here and inside the game.
Yo, this is Fatality, and I'm inside the game.
Yeah, yo!
I-D-G! Drago spamming the lovely bind of Evil's, of the console log from Evil's Pantherfaust, last match against Russia, where he had to hang his head in shame after a three-man kill. However, three-man team kill, sorry. However, Nelly comes back at me with a very interesting point. So as I'm saying, well, why should the map be changed if it gives good games? Nelly comes back with golf. They change the maps in golf every time. They never play on the same, you know, same course twice in a year. Interesting point there, Nelly. You have got me. You've got me on that one, I'll admit it. However, Nelly did raise another point. We're going to take it off subject just for a second, seeing as we're waiting on ATTV's reconnecting players, getting ready, blah, blah, blah. Tomorrow there's a huge football game, Chelsea versus Barcelona. If you haven't heard about it, I don't like you. And there's, you know, absolutely no doubt it's going to be the biggest game of the year. It's going to be bigger than the final. And it's going to feature the one and only Chelsea. However, they're starting to get a bit of a bad reputation for diving, for fouling, for swarming around the referee and so on. But my argument, and it's not an argument, it's a fact, no, we're going to play. So screw that, we'll come back with that later. Anyway, Poland versus Germany about to get back underway. Oh, we had a... No admin told them what to do, and so they are waiting on all ETTVs. I'm not sure which one we're missing, but we are missing an ETTV, so I don't think we're going to get this one out of the way. So we're going to go back to Chelsea versus Barcelona, which is tomorrow. So, we have got a big game here, and Chelsea is starting, in the UK at least, to get terrible press for, you know, their behaviour and stuff like that. And what I'm telling you is, every team that becomes good gets this press. So, Manchester United, everyone hated Roy Keane, who wasn't a Manchester United fan. Hated Roy Keane, hated Van Nistelrooy, you know, when Manchester United were good. Arsenal, hated Patrick Vieira, hated Ray Parlour, Martin Keown, when they were good. Chelsea, now that they're good, everyone hates all of them. It's just the way it goes. However, it's just the media's attempt to cause disharmony within the team and build up rivalries. It's what they do. It's what we do. I mean, if, you know, we keep reminding you that Evil last game, three-man team killed three of his players. Sky Sports remind you that Arjen Robben got sent off at the weekend. It's just the way it goes. And they'll always remind you about how horrible Michael Essien is. He's got an evil streak in him. He's related to Hitler. You know, all of that sort of stuff. What they miss out on is the fact that in that very same game when Essien fouled Haman, Momo Sissoko came up with three challenges that were an absolute disgrace. Not bad as Essien's, but collectively worse. But he didn't even get a red card. So here we go. We're going to get this game back underway. It is Germany versus Poland. You are inside the game. We are going to be live in 4, 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Bick and Sek. Over on the AI-Axis team, we have Sana, Mitus, Krysek, KRC, Mrozu, and Wyzek. Germans to set the time this time. Double five for effect in from the Polish side. Let's give you an ETTV sync up in just a moment if you miss it on the start. And self-kills coming in from the Poles. I've said it before, I'll say it again. I hate self-killers, and Sek might just punish them here. No, we'll drop by Mrozu's grenade. We've lost Pred's ETTV, unfortunately. I know Rona was on there, and he was having some difficulties. My apologies to him. He's old. He can handle it, and now we're going to see what they can do. Drago and Butch and Evil going to make their way up the left-hand side. Double allied push down the bottom. Pandafaust is waiting for them as they've grouped them up. Evil can strike here. Oh, he's not even going to need to. Bick has just walked through this Polish defense on this bottom level. Brilliant stuff from Bick and Butch. And now Bick looks down on this four-bunker gate as if it's his own. Rifle nade tossed down to this bottom level. Strikes nothing. That concrete is made of strong stuff. Mrozu with a grenade. He knew Bick was there. However, here they come once again. Sek going to meet Mrozu head on. Sek will now move for the flag. Butch is there as well. Sek and Butch will combine, drop in Mrozu. Axis flag in danger. Butch making his way to this top level. This could be trouble. If they cannot make... Oh, allied side cap in that flag. Sek will finish off on Mitos. Pred's ETTV has connected. However, this could be problems. This could be Rotterdam or anywhere, Liverpool or Rome, but instead it's Germany versus Poland, and Germany are on the ascendancy. Poland unable to set a big time on the first stage. Now, you know, if we're being honest, 90 seconds on first stage, it's sometimes pretty common. However, Poland need a big time. Poland need a 12 to 13 minute time to ease their way up. When I saw Germany on Supply Depot against Russia, they were every bit German efficient. Evil with the mortar round blows away Mitos. Evil the soldat extraordinaire as we spy Sek and Drago and Bick all ready to make their move forward. As the dynamite is going to blow in 5 seconds. Mortar round raining in at the command post. Bye-bye, Sana, who's manning himself up on that fence, and he's been dropped so beautifully by that mortar as it rains in. Nothing stopping the allied side making their way forward. With a little rifle nade comes up on Krysek. Germany pushing through this Polish defense quite happily. Krysek, Wyzek coming back at them, though. Bick and Riddler both down, and here comes Bick once again. Sieged on by the Polish crossfire, and Drago's support fire will blow away teammate second. That will hold up the hold up the defense. The rewind tag you see on the server is Riddler, who's managed to hit one of the wrong binds, I'm guessing. Evil with a mortar round, dropping Mantis. Here come a four-man German push, five-man German push. They make the charge up. Riddler's going to push straight in towards his command post as Wyzek can't get the revive in on Morozu. San is the last man standing. He drops and gives that engineer, and he's going to do it again to the second engineer. If Santa can get this, it'll be something special. He's dropped down by his teammate. Oh, no, it was Sek that was dropped down by the teammate. Rifle kill, rifle nade will just come in and give his final opponent, and command post will stay in Axe's hands for now, but there are not many Poles left up. The Germans are all dead as well, though, so that'll help. And here come the Polish reinforcements in the shape of two medics as the Germans make their move over the middle. The Germans are coming, the Germans are coming. It's Riddler, it's Kryzek with the K-43 dropping Butch. Here, self-kills, and here they come once again. Evil making their push. If they get this command post push, Mampo's pushing. The Germans are, the Poles are out for a long time, but it ain't happening. Mitos, 1, 2, double MP40 frag. Riddler with a grand frag will siege on Mitos as the medic will get picked apart in that Mampo's. And here comes Santa. Santa just swarms Riddler. A little move to the left, a little move to the right. Central charge will go in. Santa down. Drago picked apart, though. After finishing off that command post, Bick will come in, get the construction done. 11 minutes and 13 seconds to go. The Poles need another 4 minutes on this main stage. That's a huge ask. If they put 4 minutes on this main stage, though, they're in. They can win this match, or they can win this map and take it to a third map. If they don't, I fear for them. They need to be making sure that when they're falling back, 7 minutes are on that clock. Time now, 10 minutes and 53. Here we go. Engineer, main entrance, dynamite yellow. It's Bick that's there. Kryzek comes forward, drops him, gives him. Nicely done. He got the dynamite kill at the same time. Second down. Polish support for Polish crossfire in danger, though, as he's out of position. Self-kill's coming in by the Poles, though. Double, triple self-kill. Morozu with the MP40 at the same time, dropping Drago. Here we go by the Germans on the respawn. Any second now. Oh, where are those Germans? Where be those pesky Germans? Here comes Bick. Here's the respawn. Allied support, Axis support fire just outside, and the five of them huddle up in that command post because they got the call. Just a nice call. Whoever saw that one coming. And here come the Germans. There's five. They make their move over through, down the hill as they go through the wall. It's Riddler and Bick that'll rack up the frags. Polish spawn time is now. Kryzek and Son will rack up frags, and here they come once again. 1, 2, 3 players making their way out that main entrance. That main first spawn entrance, and if they'd done that, and 1 second later, they would have all got mortared. In the end, only one of them got mortared. Dynamite was yellow on the main, it got blown away. Here come the Germans once again. Riddler gonna go for the plant. Butch is there to revive him, but he put down again. The Butch is now in trouble. Oh, that's stunning stuff from KRC with a double MP40 frag on Riddler and his medic. And that is that attack all over and done with for the German players. Here they come, though, again. The engineers are moving in. Support fire is just to the left of that main entrance. Dynamite about to go yellow. Oh, no, it's not. Dynamite grenade in there. They've just both missed the grenades. And Drago's going to toss his own grenade in before self-killing. The Poles are back in position. Evil with the mortar shot from hell straight onto the top of those stairs, blowing away Sana and KRC. That's a mortar shot and a half landing on the top of those stairs. I have an FFV there, but wow, he's got that one there. But Kryzek's in on the defuse. I don't believe it. He's got it. Kryzek with the defuse, the cheeky defuse. Well, the Germans assumed they had it. I assume they had it. The Germans moved to the East Depot wall to get the dynamite down there. And he has just walked in with what a defuse that was. Mitus and Kryzek, though, have been blown away by the mortar round. And Morozu will answer back with his own support fire. But that's one only. Germans about to make the push in. Dynamite going in on the main entrance. KRC is going to push forward. He's going to drop the engine and give him Santa. Sana coming in with the MP40 frag. Butch is now going to challenge Sana and Morozu. And Sana after... Sana will drop Butch, but it'll be Sek that pushes forward. Poles in trouble. Two German medics have made their way through the East Depot wall and are now pushing down towards board. They're challenging Mitus and Kryzek. Oh, not having any of that. Butch catching Mitus with his pants down. Mitus with med packs out only. Not good enough there, Mitus. Experienced enough to be dealing with situations like that and failing this time. Kryzek pushing in, Wyzek is pushing in. Bick now will go in for that, dynamite. 8 minutes and 17 seconds on the clock. If this goes off, they will just be 30 seconds short of that target I personally set them. And, they can be pretty impressed with the fact that they've done that. However, the Axis are coming. The Axis of Evil is in position. Riddler with a rifle nade blows Wyzek away. Poles need, Germans up on this top level here. It's Butch that's there. Mitus has been picked up and Butch has been dropped. So the Poles now have their final defensive positions ready. Evil, though, the Panzerfaust, has been in top form this game. Credit to him. I'm always, whenever I shoutcast a game, I'm always heavily critical of the Panzerfaust and Soldier. Because if they're not effective, they shouldn't be there, especially in enemy territory. However, Evil has been more than effective. Now he's a Panzerfaust. Strikes it in. Double Panzerfaust off the spawn. Kryzek and Wyzek. both blown away. Credit where it's due. That's one hell of a Panzerfaust right there. 7:30 on the clock. We wait as the truck is pushed in towards that final resting place. We have got just a few more inches to go. There's an FFE on it, though, and Drago has had to hold up. Mitos dies on his own grenade. Morozu was dropped by Riddler's rifle grenade. The Germans are coming to the top level. They're being challenged left, right, and center of the poles. It's only Sana left to go. Riddler was blown away. Oh, it's team kill only. And Sek now been dropped in that command post, in that construction room. And the engineer was team killed down by Butcher's Thompson there. I assumed it was a team kill revive when I saw it in the command, in the console, but it wasn't. Butcher's just blocked that door up and filled it up with two Thompson frags. Revives have gone in, and it's been wiped out. Bix the engineer and his backup engineer have both been taken down and gibbed, and poles live to fight another day. The next German attack will be coming any second now, but there are four poles into position. They push forward. Sek, Bick, Drago, all making the move forward. 6 minutes and 40 seconds on this clock. You are inside the game with Tosspot as the Germans come. Sek, the medic, leads the assault in. Morozu, down for the Poland. Mitos will push forward. Drops, gives. Evil, the Panzerfaust, is about to make this move forward. Evil pushes in. Morozu's not going to let him. Evil vaporizing himself at the opportunity where there were two medics waiting up against the wall to be destroyed. And now, Mitos will do all the destroying himself as he comes through and drops two. As we have got Riddler about to make his move onto this top level. We have got rifle nade tossed in towards the top level as he's just making his move on his own. And the Garand frag will come in from Riddler. He's waiting on his medics quite carefully, quite intently. He's dropping grenades down on that top level. Where is Sana? Sana's the last man standing for the poles, in fact. And I don't know whether Riddler knows that he's there. Here comes KRC. He certainly knows he's there. Sana, though, will come in and drop him. He's the last line of defense. He's the only line of defense right now. In fact, no, Sana's down. KRC is about to pick him apart. KRC prone down to the back. He's been dropped by Bick. 5:43 on the clock. Drago blocks that window for any Panzerfaust shots. Bick will get the construction done. And now they will move this gold crate out. And the poles. Oh, Panzerfaust. Rifle nade. And the spawn camp is on. Nick did a hat trick with a rifle nade for Riddler. And the Germans have raged this Polish spawn up quite nicely. Evil with a grenade on Wisejet. Krasik, last man standing, drops Evil with the ACP. And he is going to have to be a huge. Oh, he's down already. So he's not going to get it. So. Germans have done the job. They have got this truck moving. However, the Poles done their job too. 5 minutes and 10 seconds on that clock. As supply depot has got faster and faster, we're looking at an 11-minute time, maybe. I'd take that. You tell me when I'm playing supply depot and Fisher, you're going to get 11 minutes on access site. I'd take that right there. Plenty time. And I think a lot of people would agree on that. So we will see quite how many more seconds the Poles can put up. They have lost players. They have been spawn raped up in the backside. And Mitos is going to make it move forward. Garand 1, Garand 2, Mitos, Krysek both down. Riddler will claim them both with a Garand. The truck is moving. Evil with the Panzerfaust. Here we go. Germans coming out of spawn. Poles coming out of spawn. Poles going down. Sek, Thompson, 1, 2. Mitos, Sana, both down. Morozu's back up and at him. He's going to push on. Drops. No, does not drop Drago. And that truck will move away. Every second counts on that truck. If they were to strike Bickoff, then it would delay it even further. However, 4 minutes and 15 seconds remain on that clock. The knife killer's in on spawn. The revive will go. And I would expect the spawn camp to come any second. Now, here we go. Evil waits for the Panzerfaust. Well played, says the admin. I'd say well played to the Poles. 10 minutes and 55 seconds. That is not a bad time whatsoever. Morozu, five kills and 17 frags. However, got more damage than Mitos, who got 13 frags. Not impressive. However, the Germans will be happy. The Germans will be very happy. We are about to push on to the Polish assault. If the Poles can do anything about it, it's going to come on this attack, and it's going to have to come on this attack. Otherwise, the Poles will go down to 4-0 by Germany. Not only is that embarrassing to the Polish team, who are former Nations Cup champions, it is embarrassing because they could have done better in this game. They have had the ability to take this game to this next level. I've been impressed with KRC. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Germany, Poland is back on the way. And now we count down. We're still playing in 10 minutes and... Well, in 10 minutes, then we know the Germans have won. And rifle nade dropped in from Krysek, blows away Riddler. However, the Poles have that much time to get this objective completed. Here we go. Germans very aggressive off the start. The Evil with the self-kill and support fire blows Wisejek away. The Germans down. Panzerfaust, not going to happen from KRC. Plucked down in midair. The German crossfire in that bottom level, lethal as it picks him apart. Morozu now going to toss forward. Grenade in. Germans about to push forward. They have four or five players on that bottom level alone. A Panzerfaust would destroy that defense. They are Panzer-friendly in that defense right there. The question is, can the Poles land it? Will the Poles land it? Here we go. Kryzek looks like he is a Panzerfaust again. Oh no, he's an engineer. KRC is a Panzerfaust, my apologies. Makes his way up that top level, but his medic is dead, and so is he. And the Germans will revive, regroup, and set up that bottom defense yet again. Sarnum like to move up the backside. Kryzek is edging down through the middle. Micus will come out on the top, and so will Morozov. Here comes his Polish assault. I swear I heard a Panzerfaust whip off right there, but he didn't land a kill, that's for sure. Bick, Drago, Evil, all racking up frags for these German players. Evil's artillery fire will take down Butch, but I'm guessing he was pushing forward for the respawn. And now, maybe not. Self-kill's coming in now from Evil. And the Germans are about to make this push. They're going to time it with the respawn. Nicely done by the Poles. Here they come. Morozov blown away by Riddler's rifle. Kryzek makes his way on the bottom level. Here they come. Morozov, Kryzek, Riddler triple landmine kill. Wow! Sarner and Mitos, though, both going to be picked up by Wyzek. They have the opportunity now. Three revive players making their way forward. Mitos picks up Kryzek. They're right outside the German front door. They're knocking. Is anyone home? Mitos and Kryzek make the push. Sarner's in on the bottom level already. Mitos claims it for his own. Sek is the last man standing for the Germans. Self kill. Kryzek, he's going to have to go for the plant straight away because the Germans are on him. He's not going to have that opportunity. Grand frag. He's in trouble. He's down. The Germans are back. We need a Panzerfaust for this Polish team right now. And there it is! Yes, double kill for the Panzerfaust. Second Drago, both down. Riddler picked apart by Morozov's Thompson. Germans in trouble. They're coming back at them though. Drago revived. Downs Morozov. And now they have four players left up on this bottom stage. And it's like the Polish attack never even happened. Here we go. 8:40 on the clock. Here, Kryzek, Sarna, both making their way down to the bottom level. Morozov and Mikus are there. Grenade forward. They're not going to land that frag. Riddler with the rifle name. Bic MP40. Evil MP40. Slowly they do it. Not going to happen. Not going to quite make it. As they will push forward to this bottom level. Here comes a Panzerfaust once again from KRC. It's a double kill. And Sarna is down on the other side for the Poles. But Wyzek will make his push forward. A hop, a skip, a jump, and a death. As Drago will get that one. Morozov comes forward onto this bottom level. The Germans have already fallen back to the flag, it looks like, because they're worried of someone getting in on the middle level. So Morozov is going to put the dynamite in. KRC is the Panzerfaust, so they should have this. But it has taken minutes. It has taken 3 full minutes for them to get this dynamite down, opposed to the German 90 seconds. And this little ratio cannot continue. It cannot. Mitos, Thompson, 1, 2, in they go. Riddler, now moving in for the defuse. Morozov called it, KRC blew it, and that is teamwork in its finest. Is there a second engineer? No, there's not. The Germans are already falling back. They had that one down to a T, like a finely oiled machine. Now they move the truck forward. The self-kills are in from the Germans, and here come the Allies once again. Morozov leads the charge for the Polish teams up towards that command post. The Axis team do not have that command post up. A quick push, and they may save themselves a lot of hassle here. Morozov is... Where is he going? Morozov on his way forward. A lone engineer, full HP. He's got Butch to aim for. He gets him. Morozov's going to make his move up towards the command post this time, but Drago called it. Drago had got the call, and here they come once again. Now the Poles edging their way forward. Command post is not up, Poland. They can't get this. Drago prone down in the thick of things at the command post. Nice position there. I've not seen that one before. As the KRC double mortar round straight in Evil's face. Anything you can do, I can do better, says KRC. And that is epitomized by the double landmine kill. Sarn has just seen the command post is not up, and he will be screaming, "Get to the command post!" And here comes Morozov. He will get that command post up right now. Kryzek double rifle nade in for the Poles. They are making ends meet here. They are making Germans cry. 6 minutes and 42 seconds to go. They need to get this main entrance while there is no German defense. They're going to make their push down. Morozov and Kryzek need the half the charge after building command post and firing rifle nade. It was KRC that was the third engineer. The dynamite is down, but Evil's artillery support reined in as Kryzek makes his way forward. He's stopped in his tracks. MP40 power by Bic. And now Morozov will go for the arm. It looks like it might fade away. Doesn't matter. Drago with a grenade has dropped him. And the revive will come in too little too late. Sarna and Morozov are there. They're going to get another revive. It's going to be Wyzek to come forward. Morozov's been gibbed. The one he didn't want to be gibbed was the engineer. And now Riddler will push forward. Self-kills on the grenade. And that will give KRC just enough time to get this. No! Panzerfaust from Drago blows KRC away as he was going for the arm. As the Germans were respawning, Morozov makes his way in. But he's going to have to run a gauntlet of grenades. And now it will be Kryzek after Morozov failed. Riddler to put a rifle in Kryzek's face. 25 seconds on this dynamite. Will there be a defuse? Riddler is still alive, I believe. Yes, he is. He's at the gate entrance. And now Riddler is going to go. Oh, Morozov, 1, 2, 3 with a grenade. Big Riddler and Drago blown away and 2 consecutive grenades. The Poles may just make a game out of this yet as they finish up the Gibbs. And now they have 5 minutes and 36 seconds to attack this final stage. Get that truck in position. Map victory. Wyzek, Mitos, both in position. East Depot wall planted. Mitos hops into position. Choo choo, he says in the back of that truck. Sarna, Wyzek, Mitos, all ready to make this move forward. Kryzek is there. FFV in on position. And now Beck with 1-2. Butchie makes it 3. Evil makes it 4. Bye-bye, Poland. Double artillery team frag from Evil. He's done it again. He's done it again. Last frag, it was two. Last match, it was 2 team kills. This match, it's... last match, it was 3. This match, it's 2. And, really, Evil is a well-oiled team kill machine. However, he did enough damage with that as a soldier in the first half that we will forgive him. 4:54 on the clock. You're inside the game as Poland look to finish off this game if they can, though. That's the question. The Germans have got this nice U-96D-style offensive supply depot next stage as Sarna and Mitos will push in through the side entrance. They've put a hole in that German defense, and now if they can spawn camp it out, they may be able to do something here. Mitos with the grenade. He'll drop it down. It's Evil. It's been blown away. Sarna needs to revive. Mitos is going to get it. Yes, he is. He's going to pick himself up in MP40 for his trouble. Morozu coming around. Rilla's going to get dropped. There's a hole at the backside. Morozu's going to fill it. Wow, that sounded gay. Morozu's going to come up with Kryzek. The two engineers make their way up the back entrance. They're going to go through. Sek with a grenade. Bye-bye, Morozu. Kryzek's coming forward. Kryzek on his own. Sek is lying away from that MP40. He just pierces it through the window. And where were the medics? Where were the medics? Nowhere at all, but Butch drops Wyzek as he tried to make his way in towards that construction. Here comes Morozu on his... Mitos on his own, and Mitos has dropped Sek. Why? The give is coming in from Sarna. Poland have control! Poland have the back entrance down. They have the front. They just have to finish off the... They have to get the engineers in position. Drago the soldier lies in wait. Bick makes his way up the back entrance. The question is, where are the engineers? Panzerfaust is waiting on that construction room. Sarna is there. Drago is lined up. Mitos forward. Mitos is going to push forward. He spies it. Panzer, Bick up the backside. Drago vaporizes himself as he goes for the Panzerfaust. Rifle nade from Red, the blows correct. The blows them both away. KRC double Panzerfaust. It's all going off. Gold is moving, though. That's all that matters. Here come the Poles. 3:30 on the clock. They can do this. If they don't do this, it'll be the biggest screw-up in enemy territory history. They have got this, though. 3:22 on the clock. The Germans are in trouble. They're coming forward. They have to lock down this truck right now. West is not blown. That is not in Poland's favor, but East is. They have got a lot of time on the clock as well. Took the Germans about 90 seconds to get that gold away. Even less, I would say. As here comes the next Polish offense. They have 2 holes to fill with players, and then we'll see whether they can do it. Sarna will make that move right now. I would suggest Evil switches to Panzerfaust ASAP, as he can stop this attack on his own. Right, mortar is being rained towards that back wall area, as Bick and Butch and Riddler will all claim frags without... Oh, now Morozu is giving some return. Mitos pushing forward. Mitos on his own after Morozu was dropped, being chased down by Drago's knife. 2 minutes and 37 seconds on the clock. Kryzek going to make his way around towards the back of this truck. He's about to hop in. Is he? No, he's got the rifle nade. He's got it loaded as well. Pings one in. Drago blown away. KRC self-kills. The truck has moved an inch. 2 minutes and 25 seconds. And the Poland team are in trouble here. They have to do this. It's all theirs. Surely they can do this. Double revive going in on Mitos, in fact. And now we'll see what they can do. 4 medics about to push in through the East Depot entrance. They've no spam at all. They've nothing to separate this defense. Spam is good in managed numbers. If they could also go through Axis Respawn. In fact, if they push through the main entrance, go through Axis Respawn, come up the backside, they have a brilliant chance of getting it rather than this predictable attack through the East. However, we'll see what they can do. Kryzek making his way forward. There are 5 Germans at the tank. There's 1 minute and 53 seconds to go. Poland are about to commit the biggest screw-up in enemy territory history. I'm telling you, this is terrible. 1 minute and 45 to go. Here come the Poles once again. 5 players respawn. No Panzerfaust. No field ops. You got 5 players grouping up in a truck and you don't have a single field ops. What the hell? I should be playing for Poland. Sarna making his way in through the East Depot entrance. KRC with a one-man Panzer blows one away. Drago dropped by Wyzex Thompson. The truck is about to be chased down by the Poles. It's still not moving. Medics ahoy. And now... taken down 3 of them. Kryzek is there. Kryzek has moved it another inch. 119. I hate to say it, but this is GG right here. This could be GG right here. Poland. Sarna's down at the track. Poland have committed the biggest screw-up in enemy territory history, and I'm only saying screw-up because it's before 9 o'clock. Oh, it's after 9 o'clock. Well, I'm only saying screw-up because there may be children listening. Swass might be listening. Here we go. Mitos. He's going to make his way in through the middle. Not going to happen. Sek drops him with an MP40. Evil going to go forward. Tosses the support fire forward. 55 seconds on the clock. This is do or die for Poland. It's all over. It really is all over. The final 3 Polish players tap out. 45 seconds on that clock. This is game, set, and match. Germany have won it in 2 maps. Poland rack up 3 quick frags there. Can they get this truck moving? They can! Last chance! Last chance for Germany, for Poland. The truck is moving. 30 seconds surely isn't enough time, but we will see. Mitos and Sana making their way forward. German respawn is on. Mitos and Sana both in trouble here. Sana gets Mitos gets dropped in the back. Kryzek trying to make his way forward. The truck is moving. It's going through the depot gate right now. 20 seconds on the clock. They may just do this. It may not be over. I may have said it too quickly. The good games are coming. 15 seconds. The truck is in the main entrance. What the hell? This could... probably not going to happen, but it could still happen. The Germans respawn here. Kryzek on top of them. He's going to boom. He only takes down one. He rebrides himself away. Truck on the hill. 3 seconds. It's too little too late. It's too little too late. The truck just meters away has been stopped. Riddler 43 frags. Certainly had a blinder there with the rifle nade. Drago 31. 33 for Evil. 34 for Sec. They had a great game, the Germans. And what happened to the Poles? Looking at their kills, 21, 26. They finished up. Wow, a huge frag deficit right there. About 50 frags between the two teams, and that was what stopped them. And the German team have won the game. And I don't believe it, in all honesty. The German team win it in two maps. But what a second map that was. However, you're inside the game. I'm almost a little disappointed. I wanted a third mapper right there. We'll be right back. This is some